pole. Let's go fishing when you're in the mood.
Canadian Sport Fishing, brought to you in part by Rapala, premium fishing gear crafted from experience. Duckett Fishing, pro-driven. Raymarine Electronics, Raymarine, simply superior. Pro Sports Boats, tame the water. What an amazing jet boat ride. A little bumpy at first. Oh. Beautiful. Look, silver. Yes. You know, you can get these fish fly fishing. You can get them on artificial lures casting. Right now I'm using the Legacy. This is the steelhead rod that's made for the West Coast by Rapala, and it's matched with that Legacy reel. And I'm using a float in a 1/2 ounce pink jig, which is really, I'd say, the hottest lure out here when it comes to getting these fresh run cohos. Come on up here, baby. Not only are they great sport, these things are great eating. Wow. What a run. I thought he was finished. Guess not. Okay, I think he's ready to come in. Come here, right there. See if I can hold him there. What a gorgeous fish. Wow. This is gonna be a take-home fish. I just wanna put my rod down in a safe place. And guess what? It's not gonna be a take-home fish. That's good. Barbless hook, I just wanna show you this hook. Look it, it's twisted. Can you see that? That's not the shape that it was in. It's barbless. That fish rolled in the line so much, it threw that hook. But you know what? As far as I'm concerned, it was landed. We're so close to the ocean that these fish are fresh run. Tracy was saying that whenever the tide rises, a fresh batch of fish comes up. So you can see these guys are like dynamite. They've got so much energy. I don't think this guy's anywhere near done. I can't believe that some of them will just twist those hooks in their 1/2 ounce jig head with those heavy hooks. Look at how gorgeous these fish are. Tons of energy. Cohos are known for rolling in the line like that. Let's see if I can lead this guy into shore. Such gorgeous fish. Come on, right there, so I can put my rod down. I got a nice rock. One thing I tell people, never put your reels down on gravel. Hey. Look it. You can see that jig just in the corner of the mouth. It's a gorgeous fish. There isn't a blemish on it. It's so silver. I tell you what, hard to hold on to. I'm just gonna try taking that jig out. Nice, the barbless hooks just fall out. Sometimes they fall out when you're fighting the fish. He is in mint condition, no marks on it. Very majestic. I don't want to hold him out of the water too long. Such a beautiful fish. Bye-bye, have fun spawning. Wow. Closed captioning is brought to you by K100. We make water burn. it. The air is so fresh here in BC. You know, when you're in the coastal mountains, it's not just about getting the fish, the hookups. It's a beautiful scenery. Today we've got really low cloud cover because we've had rain. You know, in between the cohos, you get these pinks that have so much energy. These fish come up by the millions in all the different tributaries, and they're mixed right in with the cohos. What I love about this particular tributary is that it's pretty clear. Some of the other ones have been blown out, so we've been limited where we could fish. So even this, oh, good, good release. Come on, what are you? The rod that I'm using, you know, is very versatile. You can use it in British Columbia, it's a legacy, or you can fish it in the Great Lakes. Most of the guys that fish here seriously load up with 20-pound test and a little bit heavier rods. I'm gonna slowly try to inch my way backwards. What a nice bend in this rod. It's perfect for these conditions. The one thing I found is you can't really rush the fish. The fish dictates, you know, when it's ready. Look at, you can see that bright silver. Come on. All rolled up in the line. Look at this. Tons of energy. Come on. That is a good-sized fish. Big head shakes. Right here. Wow. Look at how wide and thick this fish is. This is where you bow down to these. I'm actually kneeling down here. I want to put my reel on these rocks so that it's safe. Look at how wide he is, spanning my hand. What a beautiful creature. There, the jig is out. This is gonna be a keeper. So he's gonna go back to the jet boat. I'm just trying to get my hand underneath to show you how beautiful this fish is. Look at, isn't that a beautiful coho? Man, it's thick for its size. This is what you can expect to catch when you come here to Kitimat Lodge in BC, beautiful. Guys, rolling in the line, shooting all over the place. What a nice coho. Come on. Oh no, don't go in between my legs. It's all over the place. Oh! Unbelievable action on these fish. They've got so much power. Come on, what are you gonna do? You know, I've got such a bend in my rod. I would say to anybody, wear glasses, sunglasses or protective glasses when you hook these fish, because if that hook ever came out, you got to be careful. It's funny, I thought he was ready. As soon as he went shallow, he just turned around. Okay, slowing down. Wow, what a fighting fish. Look at, just gonna pop that hook out. Just popped out. One last look, kept it in the water. He's ready to go. So much energy. Look at, beautiful. And while watching this clear water, it'll disappear once it gets over the sand. Look at it. Oh, it's beautiful. What a sight to see. Raymarine Electronics. Raymarine, simply superior. You know, this is a classic center pin reel. It's simple, it's 1-to-1 gear ratio. Right now I have it on the clicker because I don't want the line to come off, but when you're using it, you take the clicker off so that you can cast properly. So I'm just turning the lever there. So right now it's on free spool, so you can see that there's nothing holding it back. You can actually cast pretty far with these when you get used to how to cast with them. But I just want to tell you the rig that we're using here that works so well. A lot of the anglers here will use a spinning outfit, and I have two, and they'll cast out and they'll work their jig by reeling it and shaking the rod. I prefer to use a float if I can. There are some places where the water's really fast and a float is difficult to use, but here we've got a beautiful run. So the lure that we're using, this is a 3/8 ounce jig. It's got marabou and a strip of rabbit fur. It doesn't look like much, but when it's wet, it looks really tantalizing. If you look up the line, you can see that I've got about a 30 inch leader. So here's my fluorocarbon leader. It's 15 pound test. It goes up to, there's a swivel right here. I have a bead to protect the float from hitting the swivel or getting stuck on it. Then I have a slip bobber. And then that little piece of yellow Dacron is my bobber stop. So I'm down, I'm guessing about 6 feet. So my main line is probably 12 or 15 pound test. So you can use anything you want here, but you know, if you're coming out here, I would encourage you to, if you fly fish, because these fish will hit really well. You can use sinking flies or just traditional flies, a sinking tip, or even a floating line, it works well. But I think it's so much fun once you hook a fish to actually fight it, because your hand, you know, is really the drag, because these reels have a rim spool. So by putting your finger there, you're actually slowing down the spool. It's a lot of fun, makes it a little bit more interesting, but you can still land lots of nice fish. The presentation that we're using here, you can see that once my bobber stop is at the float, I just use the rod tip and actually shake the jig as it's drifting down. So it gives it a swimming action. As it gets down a little bit farther, I use my hand, or I just let the line go out, but with control. An interesting fish. I was out of that dark water, which is rocks, where it meets the sand, and I was ready to kind of reel in fast, and that fish must have chased it from that dark looking water right onto the sand and just nailed it. Look at the size of this coho. The one thing that I tell people, not a good idea to try to land a fish by yourself. You know, if you don't have your guide close by, standing out in the current, always try to bring it into shore, but don't bring it up on the gravel. Just keep them in the water if you're going to be landing them and releasing them. The guides are so good here at Kitimat Lodge that they'll come over right away with the net to net your fish. Whoa, nice fish. Look at how brilliant this fish is. Got him by the tail. Got to put the reel in a safe place. Rocks is better than sand. I'll give you a nice look at this fish before we take the hook out and release it. Isn't that a gorgeous fish? Fresh. This is a prize for any angler that loves a tributary fish. You know, these barbless hooks are so easy to remove. Look at, I'm just gonna inch him out. What a beautiful animal. You gotta do the romance thing. There, haven't been bit yet doing that. Gorgeous. You know what? The water's kinda nice here.
Rod Runner Canada, grab and go fishing.
Nice coho. Oh. Every once in a while, I have to take a deep breath when you hook these fish up. I'm thankful for these long butts on the drift rods. And they just don't stop. You can get physically tired, but I don't get tired of hooking these fish. Now, for those people that like to eat fish, Kitimat Lodge, the guides take care in keeping your fish fresh. They fillet them properly. They clean them when you get back. They store them properly in vacuum-packed bags for you to take home. The one thing that I see when I come out here, a real respect for the fishery. So whether the fish are caught and released, or whether they're kept for people to enjoy and to take home, they're really professional. They take so well. They gotta be one of the more aggressive salmon, especially when they're silver, when it comes to hitting artificial lures. You don't need any kind of bait or anything, just a jig, spoon, spinner. I don't know if it's ready yet. It's probably gonna go as soon as it feels that ground. Oh, maybe it'll let me. I'll try to grab them by the tail, but even then it's really hard to hold on to them because they're so fresh. You can see from the shape of this fish's head, it's a small head. There's no hook or kype, so it's a female, and that hook just pops right out. Amazing that they actually stay in. She's plump, so this is a pre-spawn fish. Actually, she's fresh in. Look, you can see the sea lice right there. There's one right there. There's one there. I'm actually going to flick them off. So that tells you that this fish was in the ocean, maybe minutes or an hour ago. There's one on this side I'm going to flick off right here. So these fish are fresh. This also has been through a battle. So something trying to grab that. It could be an eagle, it could be a seal. But look at how beautiful they are. Okay, I'm just gonna swing it out and watch. Great fighting fish. Oh! So much energy. Look, it's so gorgeous. This guy had so much energy when he hit, just exploding out of the water. I'm gonna see if I can do a really nice release here without going to shore, because he's a smaller fish. Smaller fish. Anybody would be happy to get a coho this size. Look, isn't that a gorgeous coho? Come here, don't bite me. I wanna release you. It's hooked right in the maxillary. There, beautiful. Unbelievable. Every cast. When you consider that we're fishing one main run of a tributary, and there's many runs that we can reach with the jet boat, it just tells you how good the fishing is. Nice jumps. Beautiful release. Oh, what a nice hit. I just changed up from using the center pin to using a spinning outfit. And I put on a quick fish. Oh, nice fish. Oh, and I can see it nice and silver. And I can see that plug right just in the side of its mouth. Whoa! I love it when they do that on the surface. This is a 9-foot rod. It's a West Coast steelhead rod. What a gorgeous coho. Okay, just a little bit further. I got a feeling if I try to tail him, he's probably gonna slide right out of my hands. Come on. I think he saw me. Oh, not behind me. Come on in front here. Yep, touch this tail, no way. Okay, beach time. Come on, work with me, fish. Don't go out there. Just here in the shallow. Oh, he's so brilliant. Look at this fish. You talk about a chromer. This is a chromer. Look how nice he blends in with that quick fish. That quick fish is bright, but you know what? This fish is brighter. Make sure that reel is safe. Wow, look, I'll hold him up for you. Oh, you know what? He's a handful. He's brawly. Isn't that a gorgeous fish? Better keep him in the water. And there's that quick fish, look, just in the side. Single barbless hook. He just nailed it. Wow, what an experience. Right here, northern British Columbia. You come up here, book yourself a place at Kitimat Lodge. Bring all your gear, bring your fly gear, bring some gear to cast lures like this, like a quick fish, your center pin. you can have a blast here. The only problem is you won't want to leave. Look at, what a miss. I can't hold them. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna turn them. Look at this. Beautiful. Wow. Unbelievable. I've got my good friend Benjamin just to my left fighting a nice coho. I've got a nice one on a small spoon. This spoon that I'm gonna show you in a minute, I wasn't even reeling it. I was just letting it flutter with the current, and it just nailed it. Even a flashy fly works so good. I've caught so many of them on a fly called the Christmas tree that's made out of tinsel. Man, that is a nice heavy fish. You can see how beautiful that fish is in that clear water. So nice to see. You know, even in overcast conditions, I wear the sunglasses because it just helped me to see where the fish are. Oh, wow. What a fresh fish. Come here. Let me just grab him by the tail if I can. Man, he's got tons of energy. Come on. Hold on. Okay. There. Oh, you can see that spoon. This is a delphin spoon. I think they come from, like, Norway. It's just a very simple spoon. It's got a nice wobble and flash. And that hook was just in the top of the snout. It should just fall out there. See, look how tiny that spoon is. It's got a little bit of blue in there, kind of a greenish color, but it seems to do the trick. You see that? That's what you hit. Look at, oh, what a gorgeous fresh run coho. Right here from Kitimat Lodge. Canadian Sport Fishing, brought to you in part by Rapala, premium fishing gear crafted from experience. Duckett Fishing, pro-driven. Raymarine Electronics, Raymarine, simply superior. Pro Sports Boats, tame the waters. You know, I've been fishing maybe 2 hours, and I gotta be honest with you, it's nonstop. If I haven't hooked a fish on every cast, I've missed a fish. So this is no exaggeration. The fishing here at Kitimat Lodge in British Columbia on these beautiful rivers, if you come at the right time of the year for a certain species of fish, it's literally a fish on like every cast.